Tell you what, that crack is really Moorish.
I mean, you like blowjobs, don't you, Mark?
I'm eating a fruit corner, Jeremy.
I'm moving in. I'm going to be the boyfriend who pays rent. I'm her rent boy. But not sucking cock in a phone box, eating pussy on a tumble dryer.
Right. Which flannel have you jazzed on?
So are you really going to do this? Dinner for four. You, me, Big Susan, Sarah. You're such a bastard.
Steady on. My mushroom stroganoff isn't that bad.
Where's the turkey, Jeremy?
What?
The turkey. Where's the turkey?
I thought you were getting the turkey.
You what?
No turkey? You fucking idiot, Jeremy! You total fucking idiot! That was your job, you fucking moron! You cretin! You're a fuckhead! That's what you are! A fucking shithead!
It was a joke, Mark. I was joking. It was a Christmas joke.
Oh, I see. Oh.
Of course I've got a turkey. It's an organic turkey. I took ages researching it online. It's going to be delicious.
That looks like a lovely turkey. I'm sorry, I flew off the handle a bit.
That wasn't very Christmassy.
No, it wasn't. I apologise.
You really do need to get over this whole thing with your mum. You're not Hamlet. Stop being Hamlet.
Well, all right, I'll stop being Hamlet when you stop being...
He can't think of a Shakespearean character.
A massive twat.
See you.
Bye.
The gay couple. I live with a gay couple. It's political correctness gone normal.
I really like it, Mark. Do you think it matters if I'm not young, dumb and full of cum?
Oh, no. I mean, you're older and intelligent and full of cum.
Yeah, except I'm not that intelligent because I don't really understand almost any of what the news is about. And I'm not even certain that I'm full of cum.
Oh, I'm sure. How did I get here? I'm sure you're full of cum.
Maybe I should run as a bath right now.
Why not?
Ha! Diggity dog! The pizza man is here. Pizza in the bath. Soapy margarita.
Jeremy!
Shut up, Mark. Honestly. Gimme a pizza the action. Johnson? What do you want?
I want to see Mark. He called. He says he's been falsely imprisoned.
Falsely imprisoned? What a drama queen. He's not here.
That's bullshit. What have you done to him?
Nothing. Why would I...
Johnson!
Mark?
Johnson!
Mark!
Oh, for God's sake, if you're going to be like that about it.
Oh, thank you, Alan. Thank you. That's for you, Jeremy, you bloody shit. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, Alan.
Where's the door? Are you all right, Mark?
Yep, fine. Great, just the door fell out and we haven't, so I need to...
Is that normal pooing you're doing?
Yep, oh yeah.
It doesn't sound normal, Mark. It doesn't smell normal.
It is, honestly.
This is bollocks, Mark. You know the credo. Illness equals weakness. You're off the team.
Please, Alan.
Where's the fire?
No, but...
Oh, my God.
No. Just stay in that room. Stay in the nice room.
It's so disgusting. I'm going to be sick.
No, don't be sick. You can't be sick. Let's dance. Don't be sick. Go and look at the magic eye.
Oi, oi, what's all this? Jesus. Is this what you two are into? Is this your thing?
I'm sorry. I'm just so sorry.
I'll see you later, Mark. Much later.
Let's get you out of here.
No, you can't just...
Hang on, love. Quiet up.
You had to do it, didn't you? You just couldn't let me be happy. You had to go cry to Daddy just as soon as I locked you in your room for one single minute. You just can't take a joke, can you?
Jeremy, for God's sake.
So this is my big evening, is it? Me tripping my nuts off watching you do endless pooing. If I were you, I'd think about what you've done. Just have a long, hard think about what you've done.
Hey, Jez, what's up, man?
Super hands.
Pint of Guinness, please. No logo on the foam.
No logo on the foam.
Hey, don't buy into all that one, do you? What the old, ooh, I've got a clover in me foam. I'm so important. No, what you're doing there is you're drinking an advert, aren't you? Hey, shithead.
Tony came round to drop this off.
Oh, a party.
Did you, make your move?
No.
No, she was going to Starbucks to read a book. It's one of her things. Besides, the move, I mean, it's not a whole Sophie uptight situation. We're just gradually sliding into a fuck buddy scenario.
Fuck buddy?
Yeah, a buddy you can fuck. I mean, we're both so relaxed about the whole sex thing. Last time I was around there, we watched a porno. 4 in the afternoon, just me and her watching a porno. I mean, that's me. I'm just not ready for the kind of thing you're after. The whole someone to go to Waitrose with.
Yeah, I suppose. I don't want to go to Waitrose. I want a fuck buddy.
I wish I was her fuck buddy next door. We could do it through the wall. How thick is wall?
He looks like crap.
We have to make sure we've ticked all the boxes, so to speak, and kept everything above board.
Great. He'll be able to pay off the Blockbusters fine. Plus, I'll be able to order him around. Not horrible, just... Jeremy, could you file this for me? Jeremy, could you take that for me? Jeremy, could you suck this for me? Jesus, where did that come from?
Oh, shit, my natural bloody charm's only swinging it. Got to do something. Can I have a look?
Doesn't seem to...
Oh dear. Look what you've... Oh, is it all right?
Well, no, but it wasn't working when...
Oh, yes, it was. It was working fine. And then you spilt your drink on it and it broke. That's what happened. That's what I saw.
But in a sense...
Look, if we're going to do this, it's just you and me. No stress buster mini breaks, no women. Just us, a pile of Chinese food and a couple of fuck-off spreadsheets.
Oh, yes. Take me, Johnson. I'm yours.
Call yourself a mate, mate.
What?
Oh, yeah, right. What? I saw you leave her flat this morning.
She wanted bongo lessons. What can I say? The lady has a passion for percussion.
She hasn't got a bongo. You weren't carrying a bong. There was no bongo.
Look, you don't need a drum to teach someone...
Look, mate, I'm next door. I heard you. You're... noise last night.
Oh, that was nothing. That was press-ups.
Yeah, well, you certainly seem to enjoy the last few a lot.
Hey, mate, sometimes you really gotta push for the burn.
My dad died when I was 3, but I haven't let it screw me up.
Right.
I don't waste my life looking for a man to fill a dad-shaped hole.
What I really need is a good, long look at another man's bollocks.
I should do something romantic. Surely I'm not about to sing. I may be right, I may be wrong, but I'm perfectly willing to swear that when you turned and smiled at me, a nightingale sang in Berkeley Square.
He looked like he was singing. He couldn't have been singing. What are you going there?
It's a bit of crack.
Crack? Crack, Subhans.
Relax. It's not Blue Peter. Having a nice little relaxing smoke of crack.
Oh, my Lord. Oh, my fucking life. It isn't... It bloody is. Gog!
Gog?
Gog. At school, if you were going to sneeze, you'd run up and do it in his face. Gog!
Jeremy, what are you doing here?
Wouldn't you like to know, you big prick?
This is crazy. I should be working. I should be working, but I'm not.
I see you!
I'm Barnes Wallace! You're the Roar!
I'm the Roar! And no one's actually said the word dumbbusters. This is bloody brilliant. I'm having fun. And I'm not thinking about Sophie.
Hans, you realise we've only got 39 minutes left?
Oh, right. So now we're working. It's not okay for me to smoke my crack.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
What, so next you're going to boot me out for not wearing a jacket and tie?
Look, I've been here since 8. I'm just going to go and grab a coffee, all right?
Yeah, well, if you're leaving now, I don't even fucking dream of coming back.
Cor Anglais, of course. Probably plays it in the BNP jazz combo.
Brilliant. Fantastic. What did you think, Hans?
Crack. Just give me crack.
Well, I loved it. If you want to print one of those out, or whatever.
Jeremy, don't just go.
I'll suck. For crack.
Yeah, come on, Superhands, let's get you some crack.
Nice packet of crunchy nut you've got here. Pretty expensive, as I recall.
Not so rich and successful now with a piece of wood in your face.
Mm-hmm. Oi, cheers.
Look, Jeremy, we can come back again. He's got the message. You're going to pay, aren't you?
No.
All right, then, we've got our answer. Let's go.
You've got to hurt him on principle. Hit him with a fucking bat, Jez.
Why do I have to? Why don't you do it? Punch him with the glove.
Punch it? I can't even make a fist.
There you go. Free munchies.
Did you snick this?
Of course I did. You should be paying me to eat this shit.
Wow, free choco. Mmm, tasty.
The secret ingredient is crime.
No use regretting the past. I wish I'd done ancient history, but...
I thought you did do ancient history.
I did business studies, Jeremy, for 3 years, and I talked to you about it daily.
Right.
I could tell him that's all ancient history now. He probably wouldn't like that joke.
Oh, well, that's all ancient history now.
Right, of course, you're here for the tutorial. Sorry, I'm a bit slow. They'll soon knock that out of me. Along with any individuality. Not that I've got any.
Look, come on, Mark.
No, no, no! I'm hungry! Alright, I'm too bloody hungry to jump. I'm too bloody hungry to jump! I'm starving! It's not fair! It's not fair! You can't make a hungry man jump! No, no, don't! You do not just undo that!
Sophie!
Hi, Mark. Listen, can I come in?
Of course! Sophie, are you okay?
Yeah, fine. I hate him.
There, Soph, it's fine, it's okay. Come through with good old Mark.
Her breast is just brushing my side there.
Superhands has taken 4 grams of coke to relax him for his speech.
It didn't relax him.
Mark, I know it's taken us a while to get here, but this feels really right.
Please don't touch my floppy cock.
Did you try to get me sectioned?
What? No, of course not.
Well, somebody tried to get me sectioned.
Jeremy, Superhand is here. Did you try and get him sectioned?
What? Me? No. Why, did you try and get him sectioned?
Of course not.
Well, somebody tried to get me sectioned. And nobody gets Superhand sectioned.
Well, I definitely didn't try to get you sectioned. That sounded pretty convincing.
Listen, we need to get some fucking proof of ownership, right? We need property deeds. We need to get keys cut, borrow some start-up Wonga for the overheads. So, let's go over to Mary's.
Could be a problem there. Mary, see, Mary's been sectioned.
Mary's been sectioned? You're kidding! Jesus! Who's going to be next?
Hi there, Doctor. Listen, I just wondered if you could take care of Adele.
He's gone nuts!
Get off!
You need to section him. He's out of his mind.
What? I'm not out of my mind. I just need to give you some documents.
He's a loony. He was running around with his cock out before saying it was on fire. He's lost it. He thinks there's a pigeon in Catalonia that's in control of his legs.
I really don't. Jeremy, tell him.
Well, I don't know. I mean, mostly he's okay, but maybe you should keep him in for observation just for a couple of days.
Jeremy! Are you... Look, if there's anyone who's going nuts here, it's not me, it's you! That they could section you for trying to section me!
If you try to section me, Mark, you'll have crossed the line and I will section you, so help
me! Look, guys. You've had your fun with the sectioning. There's going to be no more sectioning today.
Hello?
What the...
All right, Mark. Give us 10, would you?
No, I bloody won't! What? Jeremy? How did you allow this?
What? I didn't know.
Didn't know what?
Nothing. What? I don't know. Is there a problem?
You let Superhands use my bed for... filth.
Oh, no. They didn't go in there, did they? Oh, that really is too much. Oh, I'm annoyed now. I'm so annoyed with them. That is too much.
Well, where in our massive duplex did you think they'd be? In one of the guest suites? Or the billiard room?
I can't get out. Let me out.
It's all right, Hans. It's just the handle. It's funny. You need to lift it.
This is bullshit.
Sorry, lads. Locked doors. Little switch just flicks, you know? Ever since Dad locked me in the airing cupboard to monitor the home brew.
You da man!
I'm a man!
It's you da man.
Whatever, Jeremy, let's not quibble. I'm a man.
It'll be okay. It's not like I'm going to rape him. I could rape him.
Yeah, it's great, Jeremy, getting everything out in the open, isn't it? Have you told Sarah how you're married and you've got chlamydia and you're still in love with Big Sue's?
I was just heading out. Salad and a Hawksmoor church.
Hawksmoor? My God. I think my mum's related to a Hawksmoor about a million times removed.
God, she's so posh that I, Mark Corrigan, who was privately educated until Dad's British Aerospace shares went kaput, could be her bit of rough.
Hey, Mark, sorry, but I think I might have deleted your email address book.
Oh, that's fine, don't worry.
You are in love with her.
What? No, I'm not.
Yes, you bloody are. You practically crucified me the day I changed your homepage.
Freedom in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ole, 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 ole. Feeling...
What are you dancing a jig for, Jeremy?
I'm going to answer the door now, Mark, but I'm coming back for you and your cock.
Jess, I'm so glad to see you. I was worried about you. Listen, do you want to go and cuddle up somewhere soft and warm and, you know?
Oh, I know, honey. Look, just give me 5, yeah? Wow, I'm just so tired and hungry and cold. She's going to have a hell of a job coaxing a hard-on out of me. But I bet she'll manage.
What's wrong with us wearing the same clothes? Are you embarrassed that we're...
No, not that. Just, you know, we're clashing.
We're not clashing, we're matching. That's the opposite of clashing.
You look different from your photo. Is the beard new?
I thought it would give him a bit of edge. And we're thinking of going short with the hair soon, too.
Makes you look handsome, like a policeman.
Oh, thank you. You're obviously very attractive, too.
What next? Am I going to tell her she's got lovely tits?
You're a piece of work, aren't you? I'm down the pub putting the hours in with the dad, and you're back in the house banging the mum. That is not a good impression.
I don't know. I think I made a pretty good impression.
Jeremy, please, don't smile like that. You're not James Bond, you're disgusting.
I am James Bond.
Sorry.
No apology required.
Oh, I've always wanted to come somewhere like this. I love the funny women taking their clothes off and you lot just gawping.
Wasn't the last one a bit thin?
Relax, Mark, we're relaxing. You don't want a great fat lab dancer, do you?
Oh my God, this is horrible. Oh, she's touching the tube. That can't be hygienic.
Yeah, but do you really want to take the risk of asking him? There's a chance he might just laugh in your face and call you a slag.
Could use my sauna line.
Cool, it's like a sauna in here.
Classic line. That is just a great line. Got to maneuver more dates into saunas.
I've been given another chance to be your friend. And I wouldn't trade a moment of that friendship for a lifetime of Funk Monkey Jungle action.
I understand you might be able to back up Jeremy's story about the, item found in the pool.
Oh my God, he couldn't resist.
Can I get you a drink?
Oh, I'm full of Diet Coke here, man. I haven't had a proper drink for 6 years. None of the party powder either.
Oh, right. I mean, you've been as high as it's possible to go.
Well, yeah, I suppose I have.
And you've been as low as it's possible to get.
Yeah, I have.
And what's it like when you're up that high?
It's incredible.
And what's it like when you're down that low?
It's terrible. It's horrible.
And what's it like when you're in the middle?
It's, you know, it's fun.
Wow.
Why didn't you tell me about the wanking off bit?
Sorry, I didn't think.
Yeah, well, you should have bloody thought.
Jesus!
Did you do it?
Of course I did. How do you think I got these trainers?
What's going on? Who's wanking who off?
Jeremy's been wanking off this bloke for cash.
No, I haven't. It's not...
Jeremy, that is so you. I always knew you'd end up doing something like that.
What do you mean that is so me? That is not so me.
Oh my God, I've entered an interview situation and there's a hand near my cock. This is like that dream I had about Alan Sugar and the Badger.
I have experience of managing a team.
Yeah, but this will be 300 odd employees.
Yes, but I've developed a portfolio of skills over the last 3 years, which enable me to rise to new challenges with ease.
Shit, gotta dump the evidence.
Jeremy, you've dropped your bag.
Yeah, so I have. Thanks, honey. Just act normal. I'll tell her what happened immediately after I've come.
What's going on, Jeremy?
Nothing. This is turkey. Look. See? This undercooked, disgusting turkey. Hey, Mark, would you like some?
No, thanks.
Here, eat some turkey.
No, Jeremy, it's not my turkey.
I really feel since I'm eating turkey, you should eat some turkey. It was your idea to barbecue it.
I really don't feel like eating turkey, Jeremy. I'm full.
I'm eating dog leg. I have definitely reached a new low.
What's that on it?
Oh, there's hairs on it, Jeremy.
Hairs?
It's just a hairy turkey.
What's this? Mummy?
Mummy is probably the turkey's nickname. It could easily be.
They ate Mummy! They burnt Mummy and killed her and ate her!
Look, I'll email through my references, Malcolm.
Rora, I'll call you.
Fuck off, Jeremy!
Guess not fitting my CV onto one side of A4 is basically irrelevant now.
God, probably good things didn't work out with her. She is totally overreacting. It's not like I ate her mum or her dad.
Did you actually have to eat it?
I don't know. I keep wondering that. But, you know, in the moment, it really did feel like I needed to eat it. Hey, Nance. How's the sofa?
Oh, fine. Superhands tried to sexually assault me a couple times, but I told him where to get off.
Superhands!
Sorry.
Okay, so I thought I'd start with, I will now do my best to give Mark the 6 most uncomfortable minutes of his life, and the 6 most uncomfortable minutes of Sophie's life will be coming up later this evening, courtesy of Mark.
I don't like it. I don't like it at all. It sounds like I'm going to attack her.
You okay? Fine. Bit of a wobble. I just proposed to a woman in a coffee shop and tried to get myself run over.
For the record, Nancy's not bullshit. She does love me.
Okay, sure. And I'm not a love rat.
No, of course not.
Still, good to clear the air.
Yeah, I'm glad we've cleared the air.
Lovely clear air.
Shit, Jess, I don't think I can do it. I don't think I have a good enough reason to call off this wedding.
I know a reason.
What?
I've got a reason for you not to marry Sophie. But you have to promise you won't be angry with me.
What is it? Did you get off with her?
No! God! Something else, but you've got to promise not to be angry.
Okay, I promise. Release the gold.
Okay. Well, actually, I did get off with her. I snogged her at the JLB conference.
What? You're kidding? You're my best friend and you copped off with my fiancé? You lovely bastard! This is dynamite! This is the perfect excuse! Why the hell didn't you tell me about this earlier?
Well, I thought you might be angry.
I am angry, very angry, but also incredibly relieved. It's difficult to express both emotions at once.
Look, I am very sorry.
You're not just saying this. You wouldn't just make this up, would you, to try and keep me happy?
No, of course not.
Oh, this is sweet. I am out of this. No questions asked. You shitty, faithless, backstabbing beauty.
Let me piss in that prayer bucket.
Prayer bucket? There's no such thing as... That's just a bucket.
Okay, I'm going to creep up to the bucket.
No, you can't move.
What am I going to do then? I can't hold on.
If you really can't hold it in, then you'll just have to piss yourself.
You're telling me to piss myself?
Yes, if you've got to go, piss yourself.
Is this what it's come to?
Yes, and do it quietly.
Great. And what shall I do after I've pissed myself? Fuck myself? Eat myself? You're such a...
Are you doing it already?
Yes, I'm doing it already. I'm so pathetic that as soon as you ordered me to piss myself, I started the procedure. This is what you've done. You've ground down my sense of self-worth over the years. I hope you're proud.
When are you going to stop?
Not for a bit.
Stop, Jeremy. Stop it. It's going down the cracks.
I can't stop. Stop! Oh, piss yourself. Stop pissing yourself. It's not that simple. The floodgates are open.
I'm ordering you to stop.
You're being a real dick about this, aren't you? Don't go!
You can't go.
Mark, I need to go.
The police will be here any minute, and I'm not telling them I let the burglar go. That's your job. You're an accessory to the crime.
Bollocks.
Jeremy, if you try anything, I will take you down. I'm not afraid.
Ooh, I can't wait to see this. What are you going to do? Oh my God. What are you doing? Are you putting your hand on me? Are you having a fight with me? Are you fighting me?
I'm doing what I've got to do.
I'm gonna go, Mark.
No, Jeremy.
My God, you are! You are fighting me! This is incredible! You're putting your foot behind me and you're pushing me down towards the floor! Finally, you're restraining me!
Okay, all right, I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm just gonna keep you here till the police arrive, okay?
This is...
Why hasn't this happened before? This is what it's all been leading towards, isn't it?
I'm confiscating your keys.
Oh yeah, have a good old rootle around in there. You never know what you might find.
I'm going home. What did you want to tell me?
I thought that you might be the one, but I guess probably not. So, good night.
Night.
She might be the one.
Fuck off, Jeremy.
I'm his one.
Look, Jeremy, right? This is what I'd look like wearing your jeans. Hi, I'm Jeremy. I've got loads of girlfriends and hash. Look at my jeans.
Yeah, that is a bit like me.
And what's that in your trousers?
Oh, God, it's seeping through.
Have you pissed yourself?
Yeah, I did a little bit of wee on myself, so...
You twat.
Oh, yeah, they can laugh, but I win because they think I pissed myself. They've no clue I came all in my pants.
Come on, open up for fuck's sake, it's gig time.
What's going on?
Barney's only locked himself in the bloody bog.
What have you done to him?
Nothing. Jesus.
He's a fucker!
Has he been sucking you off?
No, of course not.
Yes.
And you're not going to get in Nana's cottage, you know, so you can shove it out of your arsehole!
Okay, I'm going to head off.
But, Dobby,
I've been caught out, like Angus Dayton or Harold Shipman.
You look like a life support machine, Mark.
Well, thank you, Sophie.
So instead of giving life, you suck it all out of people!
Subhan! I love you. Don't leave me.
He's not all he's cracked up to be. Who's the really cool one? You should look a bit deeper before you go sucking someone off next time.
A sausage has gone! Oh my God, Jeremy, a sausage is missing!
Jeremy Osborne?
Wow, she's hot. Maybe she's a sort of warm-up act.
Cubicle 3.
Great, thanks. Listen, I just wanted to say I'm sorry.
What for?
For what goes on through there. I just want to assure you that I'm not the same as the rest of these feckless cum shedders. So, if you ever need anyone for a private donation, you've got my details.
Oh, you're right, Marco. Listen, I've just got a couple of mates around and we're getting smashed. Is that cool?
Brilliant. Yeah, I was going to ask if you might be able to make yourself scarce tomorrow night. I've got a bit of X stuff.
Oh, yeah, whatever. Hey, listen, Marco, you wouldn't have any fucking nose powder on the sly, would you?
No, I don't really.
Why don't you run out and get us some coke, eh, Marco?
Yeah, go on, get us some coke, you big freak. Then we can sit around watching your porno collection.
to be honest, I don't really know where to get coke and I don't have a porno collection.
Sure you do. You're getting a tubby just thinking about it, aren't you, mate? You filthy little dirt box. Hey, man! Marco's got a chub on!
What? No one's going to jerk me off, Sophie. It's just a stupid joke.
I'm not the one that's going to jerk you off. She's the one that's going to jerk you off.
Please, carry on.
Are you trying to humiliate me?
What? No. God, no.
Oh, Mark! Come and put your tongue up Lindsay's asshole. It's clean.
I have a mouth, but do not speak. I have a bed, but never sleep. What am I?
A river.
Nicholas Lyndhurst.
He definitely wants to fuck you, Mum.
Stop showing off to Mark, Jeremy.
Me? I'm not the one dressed like a prosy.
Natalie's bringing up that bag of clothes you asked for.
The daughter. I wonder what she's like. Maybe she's the one.
Do you need a hand?
No. Fine. Can you give that to my dad?
Sure. Would you like to come in for coffee?
No. Fine.
Well, if she is the one, she's hiding it brilliantly.
But it might not be ideal for you still to be living on handouts from your mother. You're what, 35?
Fuck off! Now pass me the Doritos or I'll blow my brains out!
Jonathan Dimbleby was talking about offset mortgages on some Radio 4 programme yesterday.
I always think that there's probably a third Dimbleby brother who they keep locked away in an attic.
Gummo Dimbleby.
Yes! No one else I know would have found that funny, but I was right to think it was amusing.
This is a fantastic evening. I've become a military historian, and Jeremy's future happiness rests in my hands. And I've got a tiramisu! This is fucking amazing! Let me get us some more wine, because you're going through this like a thirsty gay.
Don't mind Mark Superhands. He's a bit down in the dumps. He's been raped.
Yeah? He got raped?
A woman just continued to have sex with me after I'd asked her to stop, that's all.
Sounds like you were raped to me, Mark. Classic case.
It wasn't rape, all right? It was just a minor sexual assault. She didn't force anything up my bum. That's why it's not rape.
Well, it's not bum rape, no.
You never said it was bum rape, Mark.
The internet's going to be massive, I keep telling you.
Yeah, we'll see.
You must be Mark from Cali. Got any OJ?
Oh, yeah. I think there's some in the fridge.
Oh, Jesus. Hope I'm not wearing the boxers with the button missing. Don't think so. Think I have coverage.
Tropicana, nice. Screw the rest, get the best.
I like original. Jeremy prefers smooth, but I'm the one buying.
Don't tell me he's a smooth peanut butter man, too.
That's right. It isn't as good, is it? Is there a button there? Sitting's going to pull the thing wide open if not. Maybe it's sexy. Little glimpse of ball sack.
Oh, man, we're actually going on tour.
It's going to be brutal. On the way here, I was almost wishing I was going to get hit by a bus for my body's sake, so it didn't have to suffer the pure fucking hell I'm going to put it through.
So, what sort of stash have you brought?
What, you kidding? A band does not take a stash to a fest. You are a VI mother humping pee. Just open your gob and someone will slip in something tasty. A pill, a nipple, a bit of fried halloumi, lovely.
But if we play a Jesus gig, we'll be selling our souls.
Yeah, but Jesus is the best person to sell your soul to. That's his whole setup.
I vote you go for it.
Well, I vote no. Let's call it off.
Okay, 1v1. Mark?
Well, from a business point of view...
Well, from a business point of view, since when did the roadie have voting rights? I don't come round to your work and tell you how to run your sweatshops in Burma. Keep your beak out.
Superhands, looks like you've got the casting vote.
Executioner's Bong did a bit of Christo. Now they all live in a fuck-off bungalow in Fort Lauderdale eating cherry pie and banging cheerleaders.
I'm in. I think you made the right decision.
Callie told Mark I'm out of the band. What the hell's going on?
It's a disgrace. I'm cut up about it. I told Callie, I said, for me, this is almost a resigning matter.
Right, so are you going to walk?
Almost did, mate. Almost fucking did. I kicked off big time. But then I thought, maybe I can work from the inside. No point both of us getting kicked out of the band.
But we are the band.
Look, all I'm hearing is that you're out of the band. That's what everyone's saying. That's all I'm hearing. Jez is out of the band.
Now you're saying it.
I'm quoting. Look, man, I'm really gutted, but me and Tara want to kick back with a bit of Barchester. So maybe you should fuck off?
Right. If that's the way it is, fine. Can I take a bit of drugs?
Love to, mate. Love to, but... this is all mine, and I want it all. So, gotta be a no.
This is rock and roll! She screwed me over, now it's her turn! Let's fuck this place up! We're the hammer of the gods!
Oh yeah, take that, teabag tin.
Jez, no! She smashed my dreams. Let's smash her caravan. Come on!
I could make the best of it. Go for a freebie on the skull. He'll get the blame, I'll bank mate points. I'm golden! Ha ha, unlucky pal, I win!
Ow, fuck! There's something you should know.
Am I actually gonna do this?
Mark, you went mental.
Oh my god!
It's a mess.
What the hell happened?
Yeah, this is classic Mark, I'm afraid. He does this sort of thing the whole time. He's passive-aggressive, he won't say anything, he just smashes.
But my skull, my crystal skull!
Yeah, he hates the skulls. He smashed it and then cut his hand in a kind of mad fury.
God, how could he?
Well, he hates being told what to do in bed. He hates you for pushing me out of the band. I was like, dude, these things happen. But he was like, no! That's where he did the eggs.
Really?
Yeah. He's weird, twisted, vindictive. He draws horrible cartoons of you and then wraps them up in sausage meat and calls you a sausage muncher.
Would you say you're where you want to be in your life right now?
Fuck you. Not particularly.
These issues have their roots in childhood. How were things in your family when you were growing up?
Well, you know, my dad left home when I was 10, so...
What do you think the 10-year-old Jeremy would have said to his dad if he'd had the courage?
Dunno, just... Don't go. Don't go.
It's okay. You're in a safe place.
This is a laugh.
Don't go over there, it's a trap. Those trees are not real trees.
You know, I went to the clinic and I'm...
Knocked up with Mark's kid.
Pregnant, yeah. Well, it turns out the dates might be a bit wrong for what I thought, so...
So, what? It's not going to get born old or young, but they come young anyway, so...
No.
He's not moving into the compound. We don't need any of your orgones here, Superhands. He's staying where he belongs.
Are you going to stay in the Death Star with Captain Haddock? He doesn't value you. He thinks you're a dickhead.
Just because he's a dickhead doesn't mean I'm not his friend. I'm a better friend than you've ever been.
He may be a dickhead, but I'm showing him how to stop being a dickhead.
Could you please stop agreeing that I'm a dickhead? I'm not a dickhead.
Look, dickhead or not, he belongs here, in the real world.
You think this is the real world? The elves and the pixies and fucking Merlin?
Well, it's better than asteroids and tablets and orgones. Whoops!
Right, you fucker.
No! Stop!
No, Subans. Not the new TV.
It's bullshit.
It's just a meaningless object of attachment.
Yeah, but it's HD ready! It's HD ready!
I mean, there weren't any jobs when I didn't want a job. And now I do want a job. There are, like, totally no jobs. Not just, like, there aren't any jobs, but, like, there are totally, quite literally, no jobs.
You should just get a van. And with a van, it's like you've got an MBA. But you've also got a fucking van. Yeah? You're not just a man anymore. You are a man with a van. You get a van, Jez. We could be men with Ven.
Come on, your management, Corrigan, get it sorted.
Right. Chance would be a fine thing.
That's the thing people say, isn't it?
Apparently the reset code needs to be authorised from Frankfurt, if you can believe it.
Mark, can't you reset it?
Chance would be a fine thing, Lisa.
I know what we should do. Coffee run. Corrigan, 200 lattes.
good one, Jeff. Chance would be a fine thing. A fine thing indeed.
Saying that too often now.
Where's my fucking nugget?
I've dropped about 6 social classes since this morning.
Where's my onion rings?
This is...
You fucked this order right up, haven't you? Hey? Haven't you? Hey? Answer me!
Yes. I'm drinking champagne. I've written and directed a hit play. It's the Bohemian Dream.
Man, that was so funny. Some of the guys are saying it could be on TV.
Oh, God. Well, what a ridiculous idea. That on TV. No, not without a lot of editing. It really is a crazy idea at its current duration.
Oh, my God. There she is. Elena from the flats. Oh, she's so gorgeous.
Right. Yeah, she is attractive. Although brown rice and Pop-Tarts, chamomile tea and economy vodka. That's a car crash of a shopping basket.
Yeah, too right. I'm freezing. Let's whack it up to 29.
29 degrees? Are you insane?
I don't actually want it to be 29, but you've got to give it something to aim for. It'll get hotter quicker.
No, it won't. It's either on or off. You set it, it achieves the correct temperature, it switches off.
Oh, sure. You set it to 23, it'll be pootering along. Oh, yeah, 23, easy. Yeah, nearly there. Wouldn't you rather... Fuck! 29? Christ, let's get cracking! Gotta generate some serious heat! And then when it hits 23, we're suddenly all like, click! Sorry, already there. And the boiler will be like, what the fuck?
You want to try to trick the boiler?
Well, if the baby's not his, then it's mine. If I done the crime, I'll do the time.
Well, there is a third possibility.
It might not be a boy or a girl. It could be something else.
No.
Oh, God. Elena's front door. Hi, I'm Jez. How's it hanging? Hi, I'm Jez. How's it hanging? Hi, I'm Jez. How's it hanging?
Hi, I'm Jez. How's it hanging?
I've got to tell her. I couldn't slide this in anyway. It'd be like trying to cling film an earthworm.
So, where were we? And please, no more talk about my baby. Oh, God, what? Has she got in and torn his throat out?
What? You wouldn't think there was much
voltage going through one of those little suckers, but it packs quite a punch, let me tell you.
Shit. Okay, time to go nuclear. Look, Peter, the truth is, I'm a sex addict. I wank 10, maybe 12 times a day.
12 times?
Yes, or more. It's a disease. A wanking disease. Or more for luck, I have a wanking disease.
Right, got to go out. Audition.
Oh, brilliant. What is it?
It's a stage version of that movie Crash. You know, the one where all the different races are all the same, but they're all a bit different and it's all fine. The blackies and the whiteies, etc.
That's an interesting message.
It is, actually. I'm playing a whitey, as you can imagine.
Right. Typecast again.
Exactly.
Well, you two get along great. Gail's a genius.
I'm not a genius. I just have a very high IQ. I'm a Mensen.
It means she's very perceptive. She spots things that other people miss. She's very highly attuned.
Great. I'm the fuck pie's pastry crust. I'm holding all the disgusting ingredients together.
But Alan, don't go!
Johnson?
Alan, no, he doesn't deserve that.
He got it for the wrong reasons, but overall, probably fair dues. Oh, great. Reptile abuse. Others get raided by the police. I'm going to get raided by the Worldwide Fund for Nature.
Fuck you. Leave the name into the baby mama, if I were you. That's what I did.
You have kids?
The twins. I'm always going on about my twins, aren't I?
I don't think you've ever previously mentioned the twins.
Of course I have. The twins. The fucking twins. I'm always on about them. I bloody love them too. Yeah, I've got them in my phone. Oh, hold on. Have I? Ah, oh, I'll never forgive Orange if they've wiped the twins. Oh, that is shitty. Where are the bloody twins? Great kids. Bit lazy. Bit on the lazy side. Very rarely pick up the phone to their old man.
How old are they?
How old? Ooh, 7 or 8. What's fump in English?
5?
Yeah. They turned fump 5 years ago. So, what? Pair of 8ers, I reckon. I bloody love them too.
Shit! Oh, fuck off! It's not his fault, he's a dick! He's doing his fucking best, isn't he? Screw you!
The truth is, and I really wish it wasn't true, but I'm a paedophobe, to be honest.
Oh, right.
Oh, my life.
I mean, I suppose I always wondered whether...
I've always felt really weird around children, you know?
Right. Yeah.
Act supportive or punch his lights out.
Oh, my goodness.
Do you want to cut the cord?
No. Do you want to do some credit rating or work in a Mexican restaurant? Let's stick to our jobs.
Maybe for guys like us, Dobby was always a pipe dream.
Don't pull me into your filthy bathwater. I'm a player.
We want to show you our gratitude, Jez.
We want to make you an offer.
Threesome? Probably. God, it's like being offered a tiramisu and a dead kitten on the same plate.
Look at him. He's the worst kind of snake in the grass.
What a shit.
I mean, obviously I'd have betrayed him like that, but...
Yeah, but he didn't know that.
Yeah, exactly, Jez. Thank you. He... Oh, my God! He's that... That's my idea! He's using my idea!
You taught him the palm, but I told you the palm.
He's juicing my balls! He's trying to screw her with my cock!
Mark, in here is my pipe. My last rock. I want you to have it.
I don't want it. It's illegal.
I want you to keep it, please. It's symbolic. And if I come to you and ask for it, I want you to tell me no. Okay?
Okay.
Even if I hit you hard with wood or grab your arm and bend it up behind your back till it snaps like a fucking Kit Kat, you still tell me no, right?
With wood.
Thanks, Mark. Legend.
Okay, great. You want the jalapeno sauce, mate? Well, you can have the jalapeno sauce, but with my hot yellow pit in it. Yeah, see how you like this? I can't go. I can't piss. Come on, bladder, please let me piss in the sauce.
Mark?
Am I sacked? Should I go? I bet I'm sacked.
Jez, you need to come and get me.
What's happening?
I've accidentally run to Windsor.
What?
Yeah, I've mistakenly run to Windsor.
But that's like in Scotland or something, isn't it?
I didn't mean to. It's just the endorphins kicked in and I couldn't stop.
Okay, well, find some polythene or something to pull over yourself and a bit of weight.
race ground, and I'm sure you'll feel fine in the morning.
My legs are gone, man. I'm a jelly.
I'm paralysed.
It feels fucking brilliant.
Crack.
There you go.
Cheers.
Back to yours.
Sounds like a plan, Stan.
Thanks, mate.
It's all right, Jess. I'm just off to Dobby's, and I don't think I'll be needing to be friends with Kenneth anymore.
Okay. Do you think Kenneth might have been made redundant?
Indeed. I think Kenneth can take a hike.
Kenneth is what Mark calls his 9-inch dildo.
Happy Christmas, motherfucker.
Hmm. Didn't get four across boat, but they aced solipsism. Who was this person?
I think we should put the whole thing on ice.
You mean us dancing on ice?
No, like they put dead bodies on ice.
Is this about last night? Because I can do better. I know I can. I didn't even go down on you, which is a great shame because I love to go down on women, don't I, Mark?
Rinse and repeat. Always with the rinse and repeat.
I tell you, man, she is the one. I'll take a bullet for her. I'll take a bullet up the arse for her.
Oh, that's nice.
I'll take a fucking truncheon up the arse for this one. Or an umbrella. I would open an umbrella up inside my arse for this one.
Mark, Jeremy, Superhand, and a woman. You're all here. Gosh, have you come straight from the harbour?
It's fancy dress.
How fancy? Is he going to be okay?
He's going to be fine. He's moving into Superhands' party pad. They're going to have the time of their lives.
I know what you're doing, Gerard.
What's that, Mark? Being quite ill.
I've got my beady eye on you.
You're barking up the wrong tree.
She's not interested in romancing the stone, Gerard. It's no dice for you and your sickly ways.
Yeah. We'll see about that. I'm playing the long game.
Where's your inhaler, G-Man?
Maybe in the spare room. Ken took the last of his stuff. It feels funny to be all alone. To be honest, if I could just find a pal, I'd ask them to move in rent-free. Don't worry, Mark. I'll take good care of her. Very, very good care indeed.
I love you, Mark.
I like you too, Jez.
Okay, here goes. At least I'm the first one in. Hi, Robert Grayson. I'm Mark Corrigan. Hi, Robert Grayson. Pleased to meet you. Hi, Mr. Grayson. Pleased to meet you.
Mr. Grayson's ready for you.
Thank you.
Hi, Mr. Grayson. Pleased to meet you.
Hi, I'm Robert Grayson. Pleased to meet you.
This is prime therapy time. Oh, I get it. The lady doth eat bargee too much, methinks. I've seen behind the curtain. Ahoy there, moral high ground. He's wasting 500 of my pounds, and it feels fantastic.
Hi, Jez. How was your session?
Oh, good. Yeah, amazing. Reckon I'll be cured soon.
Cured? Did they use that phrase?
I don't really want to go into it, but we hit upon a lot of key issues. Me and Dr. Bargee.
Well, they certainly cost a pretty penny, so I imagine they must know what they're talking about. I guess you won't have had the chance to get anything to eat.
Oh, no, that's right.
I thought so. So I've got us both a lovely big curry as a treat.
Oh, good.
Come on, sit down. Tuck in. There's Bargee's.
Is he fucking me? How would he know? Unless he drives around in a Jeremy detector van.
Chicken tikka masala, Balti tiger prawn, vegetable korma. I thought I'd really push the boat out. There's a naan and a half each.
Lovely.
So, are there any particular school your therapist, Jez? I'm interested.
Oh, you know, a mixture.
A mixture? That is interesting. Have some of the Lampasander. It's incredibly rich and creamy.
You're such a bastard.
I've bought you a lovely curry. What's wrong with that?
You know, don't you? You know exactly what's wrong with it.
No. Just tell me. Just say it and it'll all be fine. No more curry. No more problem.
I'm not saying it.
Then eat up.
Alright, I didn't go to the therapist. I had onion bargees instead. You're the king, I'm a piece of shit. I piss it up the wall just like I piss everything up the wall. Happy now?
Yes, I am happy now.
I'm a shithead. I need help. I need therapy.
Hey, Jeremy. Gerard's died of flu.
Bullshit.
Seriously?
Bloody hell. That is so Gerard. You're
never going to be a life coach. It's just another dream, like being a pop star or a front bottom inspector.
That wasn't a career, that was a T-shirt.
Yeah, well, a front bottom inspector is still a more realistic career option for you than life coach.
I threw that T-shirt out months ago. You know why? Because it was tasteless.
No weed at all.
I'm not muffing the fucking drugs meal, mate.
Why do you think I invited you?
For my off-key remarks and crazy insights.
Right, Jess and Hans, go.
Widely acknowledged to have nicked our sound.
The Chemical Brothers.
Correct. Bullshit as turning wank into cash.
Flaming Lips.
Correct. Oh, arsehole.
LCD sound system.
Fakers.
Pavement.
Yep. We thought we had a number and you got a bit overexcited, but it turned out to be a not very funny joke.
Lily Allen.
Correct. Phonies.
Foo Fighters.
Demanded the Ramsgate blowjob.
Mumford and Sons.
That's your lot.
Round one to you, Simon. Next time we do a quiz, it'll be on Napoleon. And while you might scrape through a few Waterloo questions, when I pin you down on the Emperor's domestic reforms, I will fuck you very hard in the mouth.
Listen, Mark, I'm sorry about earlier, but I am going to have to be on your case pretty much permanently from now on. Belittling you, if needs be. No hard feelings, though, yeah?
In a way, I'm pleased. It's made me finally decide to do something.
Still plenty to live for, Mike. You got a kid.
Not suicide. I'm not suicidal.
No?
Do you want to buy some ballet shoes, do you, mate?
How much?
Jess!
You all right, mate?
Jess, am I mad?
That's a bottle of twats.
Are you single yourself?
Yes, I have been for a while.
Okay, interesting. Where the fuck did that come from?
Oh! I just wanna fucking suck, fucking suck, fucking suck, everyone. I just wanna fucking suck, oh, the whole night through.
What about going Litvinenko?
Kill him? With polonium?
Not full Litvinenko. Just a little bit of something debilitating in his pasta each night. Grind him down, weaken him, till he's all pathetic, and you can just scoop him up like a sick whippet and dump him. You might quite like tending him as he grows weaker and weaker.
Here's your tea, Jerry. God, you must get better soon.
Oh, do sit up, Jerry, while I spoon you some more of this slightly silvery porridge.
Sorry about the garrotting. In fact, I've a nice lift home for us there, and, well, you didn't break my nuts about it. That's what real mates do. They take a pounding, but they still come up smiling. A bit like Jez with that bloke in your bed.
God, has the entire world seen this fucking video? I came here to talk to someone about this, get some perspective. Turns out I can just read the fucking YouTube comments.
Yeah, there might be good comments.
April from Darty's coming over as it happens.
The girl from the shoe shop. You finally tracked her down and you're luring her back to your lair to eat her with pasta.
It isn't a lair, it's my flat. And my sole subterfuge is that she thinks she's coming to a dinner party, but I've got a feeling that the other guests may cancel at the last minute. Naughty, unreliable guests.
Finally, I'm rubbing off on you.
Jez, I think she might actually be my perfect woman. She's a serious academic historian who got my joke about Indiana Jones. She just texted saying, Professor Jones has her whip ready. I think it's probably the sexiest text anyone has ever received.
Wow. You should go the full indie. I love you on the eyelids.
Brilliant. But far too mad.
Go on, it'll be hilarious.
I was thinking, how can I turn up the heat? I could blink at her as she came through the door.
More than hilarious. It'll be a hoot.
It would be a bit of a hoot, wouldn't it? But it's the sort of thing you'd think about but never actually do.
Not on my watch. Come on, you've tracked down the love of your life. Go for it.
No, Jez!
Yes, Mark. This is what real friends are for. Making you do brilliant things that you'd never do otherwise. This is how the old Doo brothers roll.
God.
Right then, hold still. Come on, Mark.
Oh, this is crazy. You're mental. How does it look?
Don't blink, don't blink.
Hi, Mark.
Hi, April.
This is Angus.
Just got to keep my eyes firmly open. That's the most important thing.
We bought you some chocolates instead of wine, because everyone always brings wine, don't they?
Oh,
Lovely.
That'll be one bottle of wine between six, then. Perfect.
So you and April were at Dartmouth together?
Yes, briefly.
Almost unbearable urge to blink. Ah, lovely, lovely blink. Enjoy it. Last one of the night.
Shall we go through? Help yourself to hummus. It's freshly made and, if I say so myself, quite delicious.
Unlike the rest of the meal.
Cocktail?
Rum, water, lettuce, vinegar, and the secret ingredient, salt.
April said you were off to a conference.
Yes, date mix-up. But I think April will be able to join me. I'm actually talking tomorrow on transcultural memory in the Ottoman Empire.
Oh, look who's won the lettuce lottery.
Wow, this is
It's Moroccan. I love it. It's quite subtle.
Blink impulse off the scale and drink disgusting.
I've sort of ended up sleeping with both of them.
You're humping them both?
To be honest, it's getting quite tiring, especially when I have to do them both in one day.
Oh, that must be really hard. I'm so sorry for you, Jez.
Do you dig in?
What is it?
It's Moroccan, like my eyeshadow.
It tastes like baked beans on spaghetti with lettuce.
Right. Hate to call you a racist at my dinner party, but I think it's a little more sophisticated than that.
Ooh, hello. Naughty, naughty Megan.
Am I betraying Joe or Megan more? I like him loads, but I'm her life coach. What the fuck? Joe? No, don't cross the streams. Shit.
What the hell?
That was actually Mark's foot. He does that sometimes, for laughs.
What?
Put your foot in my groin under the table.
No, I don't.
Mark's got his shoes on.
He's quick. He slips them on and off. It's part of our flirty, dirty game.
I have no idea what he's talking about.
I love this office.
It's £400 per calendar month.
Four? 400? Fuck my mouth!
Eye of the tiger. Fuck you, everyone. Fuck you, Dad.
Delicious. As always. Mine compliments to the chef.
Christ, it's gone all the way up my nose and into my throat. Doesn't taste very nice. What if it's off? What if my head swells up like a melon and I never sleep again?
I feel completely normal. But also, a bit like I want to karate chop my hand through a very high stack of poppadoms.
You could hold up a keema naan and I could punch my fist through it.
Kung fu'd.
I have never been this intensely funny.
Mark Smash!
She thinks I'm funny.
Mark Smash!
Oh, my God.
I should get going. But thank you for an amazing evening.
I've kissed her. I've kissed her on coke. If we take smack, maybe she'll get divorced and marry me.
I wanted to have a big talk with Angus last night. He was okay, but he was writing to the Pope. He sometimes thinks he might be able to heal the great schism.
Cuckoo!
Intellectually, he's scintillating, but he'd never take coke and throw an iPad out the window.
Yes, well, that's just how I roll.
Who complained?
Well, Mr. Osborne has been in contact to say that he believes that the granting of this loan to him was out of proportion with the just working of the universe. He does not wish to be responsible for another Greece. And he's claiming mental incapacity due to the influence of the internet reducing his attention span against his own will.
Not all been easy with Angus. Just had a mini row because he didn't want to spend an extra £300 on a cabin with a porthole. If you're going to be on a boat for 3 months, you want a porthole.
Of course you do. Who wouldn't?
£300 pissed straight out the porthole. Correct call, Angus.
Wow. Okay. Wow.
What?
It's Angus. He's been having a think, and he's not sure we should go on this cruise.
Oh. All right.
Furrow the brow. Furrow the brow to hide the smile.
Shut the fuck up.
Here you go, you naughty monkey.
Drink it nicely this time. Not gulpy.
Hello, Jeremy. Surprise.
Come on in. Thanks for coming, but put that in the fridge if you want.
Why did you invite her? She hates me. I stole her boyfriend.
Sorry, but when I was doing the invite, it became clear that you've betrayed everyone you've ever been close to.
Oh, I've driven him away with my horrible oldness. Yeah, Megan, you're 29 now, but one day you'll be like 56.
Oh, fuck. Got to keep the attention.
If I could just say one more thing. Jeremy, Jez, please always keep on
being you.
Totally meaningless. I'm going to get rumbled.
That is sweet. That might be the nicest thing he's ever said.
Mark, will you pull me off?
I'm not about to pull you off, Jeremy. And if you think about it, I'm sure you don't really want me to.
Sure, whatever. I just thought it might be comforting.
But what about I read to you from Napoleon's correspondence?
If I was going to kill you, I'd have a great sign-off.
Yeah?
You always loved history, Mark. Well, now you can be part of it. Bang.
Yeah, not bad. Not bad at all. I think I'd just come at you in the night. Pillow on the face, cark.
Yeah, that's you all over.
Oh, we do love each other, really.
I simply must get rid of him.